Hello, my name is Alyssa Reese, and welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology Video Series. This video will review the normal histology of the gallbladder using virtual slide number 71. The gallbladder is a small organ located in the upper right portion of the abdomen beneath the right lobe of the liver. It is composed of three parts, including the fundus, the body, and the neck. The gallbladder is comprised of many distinct layers, including the mucosa, muscularis propria, and the adventitia, sometimes with peritoneum or serosal coverage. The inner portion of the gallbladder consists first of the mucosa. The mucosa is this series of branching folds that includes both the surface epithelium and lamina propria. The surface epithelium is an absorptive epithelium, distinguished by microvilli and columnar cells with basally oriented nuclei. As you can see, these cells are tall and uniform throughout the layer. It is also on this layer that tubuloalveolar mucus glands can be identified in the neck region of the gallbladder. Tubuloalveolar mucus glands are important in the secretion of sulfamucins, silomucins, and neutromucins that have many functions, including protecting tissues and also helping to regulate some of the biological processes that occur within the body. Directly deep to the surface epithelium is the lamina propria. The lamina propria is a layer of loose connective tissue. Within this layer, one can identify lymphatics, blood vessels, collagen fibers, fibroblasts, and sometimes chronic inflammatory cells. Unlike the majority of the GI tract, there is no submucosa present between the lamina propria and the next layer, the muscularis propria. This muscular layer of the gallbladder is made up of oblique, circular, and longitudinal smooth muscle fibers layered in an indistinct pattern. It is the muscularity of this layer that allows the gallbladder to contract. Powerful contraction occurs when signaled to by the hormone cholecystokinin, or CCK, that originates in the duodenum of the small intestine. Contraction stimulates the release of bile, a substance that aids in the digestion of lipids, into the cystic duct, which leads to the common bile duct that connects with the duodenum. Within the muscular layer, one can also identify Rockatansky-Aschoff sinuses, an interesting characteristic specific to the gallbladder. These are outpouchings of the mucosal layer within the muscular wall and sometimes subserosal tissue. Also termed entrapped epithelial crypts, these sinuses are not abnormal but can be associated with cholecystitis, inflammation of the gallbladder. The last layer of the gallbladder differs depending on whether you are looking at the portion of the gallbladder that is adjacent to the liver or not. The adventitia is best identified where the gallbladder is next to the liver. The adventitia is made up of perimuscular connective tissue that is very dense. Within this connective tissue, one can identify collagen, fat, large blood vessels, nerves, and a lymphatic network. In contrast, the free edge of the gallbladder that is not connected to the liver demonstrates serosa or peritoneum with a thin layer of mesothelial cells, which are not well visualized on this virtual slide. Overall, important aspects of gallbladder histology to remember are firstly that the innermost mucosal layer is made up of the simple epithelium and the lamina propria. The simple epithelium consists of columnar cells with basal nuclei, and also tubuloalveolar mucus glands can be found in this layer within the neck of the gallbladder. The lamina propria is a loose connective tissue layer that connects to the musculus propria, a muscular layer that contracts when stimulated to by hormone CCK. Rockatansky-Aschoff sinuses can be found within the musculus propria, especially in cases of chronic inflammation. Lastly, the final layer includes the dense adventitia, where the gallbladder connects with the liver, and the serosa that surrounds the rest of the gallbladder as it rests in the abdominal cavity.